Welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics. And what we daily discuss two topics. And in this manner, in 6 days, your 12 subtopics are covered, and this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because in 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion, friends. So today is lecture number 15 of geography. So let's see what are the questions of today. First is two. People A and B claim to own a certain space outside Earth. A claims a space that is horizontally much wider than that claimed by B. Which of these observations will be correct in this context? So here the question have been asked. Question is that A and B own a certain space and that is outside the Earth. So the space that A owns is quite wide as compared to the space claimed by B. So we have to choose that which of the following observations is correct. A space is more likely to have multiple time zones as compared to that of B. B's space is more likely to have multiple time zones as compared to to that of A. C, depending upon the vertical distance between the space and regions of A and B, time distance will vary. And D is there will be no time difference. There will be no difference in the time zones in any of the spaces. So here we have to choose that which of the statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer is D. There will be no difference in time zones because the space is outside the Earth. So the answer is D. So this is the answer of first question. Let's move on to the second question. Before moving to second question, let me tell you, friends, that earlier what we used to do, we used to give the explanation also. But now we have changed that strategy. In case you want to get the explanation of all the questions, you have to subscribe to the PDFs. And these PDFs, you can subscribe to them by mailing us at this email ID, or for that matter, by contacting us at this contact number 8968426481. So there is a certain cost associated with these PDFs, but it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability. So in case you wish to join to get these explanation PDFs, you can join to our initiative. Let's move on to the second question. Second question is, the Suez Canal provides a direct trade route for ships operating between first European ports to South Asian ports, second American ports to West African ports, third Chinese ports to South Asian ports. So we have to choose the correct answer. Friends, the correct is one only, that is European ports to South Asian ports. So answer is C. So if you have seen the map, then there will be not much difficulty in answering this question. Let's move on to the next question. Third question is, replacement fertility rates often heard in news are those rates at which A, maternal mortality rate would be constant, B, birth rates would become zero, C, population would stabilize, D, infant mortality rate would become zero. So friends, the answer is population would stabilize. Because at this time, at the replacement fertility rate level, the death rate becomes equal to the birth rate. So the population becomes stable. So the answer is C. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, in India, which of these states UTs are well known for the production of oil seeds in India? First, Chandigarh, second, Rajasthan, third, Tamil Nadu, fourth, Madhya Pradesh, fifth, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So we have to choose that which of these are known for the production of oil seeds. Friends, let me tell you that your UTs, they do not contribute much in the production of oil seed. So the answer is naturally 2, 3 and 4. So Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu and Madhya Pradesh would be the answer. So here it is 2, 3 and 4. So the answer would be B. That is 2, 3 and 4. Let's move on to the next question, the fifth question. So the answer of this question is B. Let's move on to the next question. Fifth question is, which of these factors are responsible for the problem of land degradation in India? First, forest fire. Second, improper irrigation used in farms. Second, intensive extraction of groundwater. Fourth, monoculture crops. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that all of these are responsible for the land degradation, because intensive extraction of groundwater takes place in case of the crops which are water intensive. So and the rainfall is not much. So obviously, if you are extracting groundwater, then there will be evaporation in the those in these high temperature areas. So evaporation, due to which the soil becomes lime, because the salt remains behind after evaporation. So the answer would be D. Let's move on to the next question. Sinai Peninsula lies between A. Mediterranean Sea and Red Sea, B. Red Sea and Black Sea, C. Arabian Sea and Gulf of Aden, D. Gulf of Aden and Red Sea. So friends, let me tell you that answer is Mediterranean Sea and Red Sea. Basically, Sinai Peninsula is the only kind type of only land which connects Asia with Africa, and it is Sinai Peninsula is the part of country Egypt. And it is quite important in the history as well, because it was invaded by Israel, and it was captured by Israel. Later on, it was transferred again to the Egypt. So this Sinai Peninsula is the only part of Egypt which lies in Asia. So Russia has also has some parts that lie in Asia and some parts in Europe. Similarly, Egypt has also some its territory mainly lies in Africa, but Sinai Peninsula of its territory is in Asia. So the answer is A. Mediterranean Sea, it is in the north, and Red Sea is in the south of it. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, what is the correct north to south order of these major ports of Africa and adjoining countries? First, Port of Durban. Second, Port Elizabeth. Third, Port Louis. Fourth, Port of Lisbon. Let me tell you, friends, Port of Lisbon. Lisbon is a place in Portugal, and this Durban, Port Louis is in your Mauritius. And Port Durban and Port Elizabeth are in South Africa. So Port Elizabeth is in down south of South Africa. So the answer is 4312. So if you know the place of Lisbon, then you will be able to answer this question straight away, because no other option starts with the fourth port of Lisbon. So the answer is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, Todas and Moplas tribes can be found in the states of A. Rajasthan and Nagaland, B. Tamil Nadu and Kerala, C. West Bengal and Odisha, D. Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Friends, this is also a quite easy question. If you have read about the history, then you will be modern history, you will be able to answer this question, because Mopla peasant rebellion that erupted in 1920s. It is a significant event in the Indian history. So the answer would be B, that is Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So the Todas, basically they reside in the Nilgiri area, and this Moplas reside in Kerala. So the answer is B. In detail explanation is available in explanation PDFs, to which you can subscribe. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about the Coral Project of NASA. First, it will evaluate the state of existing rainforests and their evolutionary future, discounting for climate change. Second, it will survey keystone species in the harshest climates on Earth, which are the edge of a Goldilocks zone. Third, it will assess the conditions of major reefs of the world through remote sensing. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer is third only. It is a basically a project which assesses the major reefs of the world, like in Hawaii, in your Great Barrier Reef of Australia, to basically assess the their condition, and using remote sensing as well as using your in-water equipment. So the main purpose is to assess the condition of corals. So the answer would be third only, that is C. So let's move on to the next question, that is the last question of the day. Which of these regions is most visited global medical tourism destination in India? A. Chennai, B. Kolkata, C. Ahmedabad, D. Indore. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is Chennai. Chennai is also known as India's health capital, because there are large number of medical tourists that come from abroad, and they go to Chennai for the treatment purposes, basically because of the low cost there and low waiting period, and also due to availability of facilities. So the answer is A.
So this is all about friends today's lecture. If you like the video, if you like the questions, then do hit a like to our video and share it with your friends, and also subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the notifications regarding updates that we do on our channel. And lastly friends, in case you want to get the explanation PDFs, you can email us at this email ID, or you can contact us at this contact number. So there will be minimum cost for which you will have to pay for the subscription purposes, but that has been kept as minimum as possible, so that you people can also afford at that, and also we people remain motivated to help you people. So this is all about friends today's lecture. Thank you. Have a